Hey everyone, we're gonna meet up with my friend Madison, who's a beekeeper, and she's gonna teach us all about bees. Let's go. Hi Madison.
Oh, hi Caitie.
Why don't you tell our friends a little bit about where we are and what you do here?
So I'm actually an urban beekeeper, so I take care of bees in the city. And so we're actually on a rooftop in downtown Toronto where it's a home for 3 honeybee hives.
And here they are.
And here they are.
So it's great that there's bees on rooftops, so even in big cities we can still have bees, because I keep hearing about how bees are really important.
Yeah, so bees are super important, especially for our food. So bees are the ones that create fruits out of flowers. So without honeybees, all of the beautiful apple tree blossoms wouldn't turn into apples at the end of the season.
Oh, so we need the bees to have all the food that we're used to eating.
Absolutely.
And they make honey too, and we eat honey.
I find city bees make the best honey.
So is all the honey in these hives?
Yeah, it is. Would you like to take a look?
Inside?
Inside the beehive?
Yeah, okay.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
Right, so this is the beehive.
Well, if we're gonna open the beehive, aren't we supposed to have like a bee suit or something?
We don't use them because we're super nice to the bees. So long as you move really slowly, the bees aren't gonna sting you.
So bees are usually really friendly.
Bees are really friendly. Okay. They only care about flowers. They don't really care about us.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Great. So the first thing I always do before I go into a hive is I have my smoker. So that's this really fun thing right here.
Look at that, it's like a chimney.
Exactly, it's a chimney with a spout. So bees can talk through smells. So there are guard bees whose job it is to make sure that no intruders get into the hive. But if I use this, it covers up all of those smells so the bees don't know that we're going in and we're all friends.
Great.
So in this bottom box, this is where the queen is. So that's where all the baby bees are.
Hmm.
So we'll check in and see how they're doing.
Okay.
So I'm just moving nice and slow. So, oh, this is a heavy one.
Wow.
Yeah. So you can see, this is a great frame. There's lots of fun stuff. So in the corners here is all honey. And in the middle, do you see all those beautiful colors?
Yeah.
So that's all pollen. So bees need both honey and pollen for their food. So right there, they have a little bit of pollen on their back legs. And this girl right here, so she's doing the waggle dance. So she found some flowers not too far away. And she's actually telling the other bees where they can find those flowers.
By waggling.
By waggling, yeah. She's telling them how to get there, how many bees to send, how far away it is, all in a dance.
That's so neat. So this is all honey underneath that waxy coating they put on top.
Yeah, so we'll see. We'll find another honey frame to show you both stages. So this is a frame of fresh honey. So you see all of this liquid gold shining in the sun.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's all fresh honey that the bees have brought in this summer.
Wow.
So they're visiting lots of flowers all across the city, and they're bringing the nectar back and storing it in each of these cells. And then the bees will fan their wings and flap away all of that extra water. And then when it's all done, they'll coat it with a little bit of beeswax.
To let you know it's done.
Let you know it's done, exactly. And we know that it's ready to eat.
So how do you get the honey from out of the frame into a jar?
So to answer that question, we'll have to go back to our honey house.
We'll go to the honey house.
Absolutely. Let's go.
Okay, let's go see it.
Well, welcome to our honey house.
Thank you. So this is where those big trays of honey come back to.
Yes, I actually have one right here.
Aha!
Yeah.
And you can see all the honey in it. It's full.
So we have to free all of the honey from this frame and make it into a liquid. So we take this special fork here.
Yeah, it looks like a big comb.
Yeah, it has a lot of little tines because what we use it for is to lift off all of the wax capping. So that's all the wax that the bees use to seal the honey inside. We lift it all off so the honey's oozing out, get really sticky. So you have to lick your fingers a lot. And then we put it in our extractor.
Whoa.
Yeah. It's such a fun tool.
It's like a big tub.
Yeah. And so we stick the frames inside the extractor. This one can fit two. And then we have to spin it all out. Do you want to try?
Yeah, can I spin?
Yeah, I'll hold it down.
Okay.
Whoa.
So you spin it around and then all the honey flies out.
Yeah, it flies all to the sides here. So it's all caught on the sides and then it drips all the way down. Mm. And then we open up this thing at the end, which is our honey gate. So then we have a flood of beautiful golden honey that comes out of the bottom here.
Just pours out and into the jar.
Exactly.
And then that's what you eat?
That's it.
Amazing.
Would you like to try some?
Yeah, I'd love to. I can't wait to see what it's gonna taste like.
Amazing.
There you go. Okay, there we go. Oh, that's so sweet. That's so yummy.
It's kind of like caramel, like toasty.
Yeah, you can really taste the sort of, I feel like I taste like a bit of flower, like wildflowers.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm.
Really yummy. Well, thank you so much for showing us all this honey and how you make honey and all the bees. It's been really fun, Madison.
Yeah, it's been lovely to have you.
Yeah. Well, we love bees. Go bees. Okay. Thanks, Madison.
Thank you.